not good.
What does it stand for? We have no pause
A
button.
For Apple. Pause button didn't work.
Or asshole.
Millennialx debut. Reacting for you.
All right. I'm ready. I wasn't ready for that.
This is a good start.
It is. Great. All
right. You guys want to laugh, right? All right.
All right. Millennialx, like you said, we're doing some reactions. We're called Millennialx because I am a millennial. This is my brother, Bill. I'm Bubby. He's 10 years older than me. He's Generation X.
All day.
Millennial. So that being said, we're going to do some music from his era. And then, because I haven't heard a lot of the old school bangers and the rap and even the rock. And we might, who knows what we might get into.
We like it all.
Yeah.
We love music, so.
Yes. And we were going to do some, what was you thinking?
Maybe some challenges between us two.
Yeah.
So
generational challenge.
Yeah. Or a most lyrical challenge. He'll pick a song. I won't know about it. I'll pick a song. We'll put them out there for you guys to vote on. And just get the brag.
We were thinking of
whoever went.
Stuff like that. And also videos, crazy videos, challenges, whatever you guys want.
Yep.
So that's what we're about. We're going to start off with an old school banger that he threw out there at me. I have not heard it.
Yep. The video, I didn't know there was a video for this song, but I've never seen the video. I've listened to the song a bazillion times, so it's awesome. So I'm excited to see the video.
Yeah, I'm excited to hear the song. So, I mean, I like Korn and a little bit of Ice Cube, not a whole lot, but that's, again, the generational gap thing that we're talking about. So let's get it.
Let's get it.
Death, your productivity is low.
Is this in the original? The intro like this?
I don't think it's. There is a devilly voice, but this seems a little different.
Because I know how the video goes.
I think it starts out like Ice
Cream. Oh,
yeah. I got another name for your list, and don't screw this one up.
Oh. I don't know if I have heard this.
You may have.
We'll see.
Still great.
Yeah. The beginning there is ringing a bell, but
I've probably played it around.
That's probably where I heard it. Oh yeah, it's ringing a bell. I don't remember the lyrics.
The voice of the man they call the Trojan horse. Pride on the outside with inner force. Throw you off course, of course. You missed the runway. We mashed like the first kickoff on the Sunday collisions.
So
his voice is just
this says
awesome.
Featuring Korn, are they just the instrumental?
They are the instrumental. You can hear it gets heavy during the chorus. You can tell it's Korn-esque, you know. No singing in the I don't think there's any singing.
They
in
just
this
throw in the instrumental.
No, I think they just do the instrumental.
Yeah, I know the beat and I know.
Yeah.
I don't know the rap part, but I know that intro.
I just feel like this era of my life, this brings me way back. There was so much effort put into music and their videos. Like everything was so.
Yeah.
It seemed like it, I don't know.
Took a lot more effort.
Took a lot more
effort.
Yeah,
I know what you mean. I've
so much.
Some of the new videos just seem like they're.
They're
turds. Yeah,
I mean, and the music doesn't seem the same, but you got a band and a rapper together, and it's just, it's a beauty.
Yeah. I do like the beats and the instrumentals of the older stuff that I know. But
yeah. I was gonna think say, that's why they kept going. I mean, they made like three other songs together then, and they were all amazing.
This throws you back to the old systems in the car.
Oh, yeah.
I remember the...
I would love to bring it all back. I always have a system in my vehicle. I love loud music.
Hey, Mr. Media, look inside your encyclopedia 2002. See Ice Cube, fuck a five-star. I'm a live star. What you got to die for? Who you want to ride for? Fuck Donnie.
Yeah, I remember that.
Yeah. It was like voodoo. Bass, man.
It sounds like orchestra almost.
Yeah, it fits well.
Yeah,
together.
I don't know.
It's the suspect king of the roughnecks, bonafide worldwide. Your highness is the finest, biggest China nigga rhymer, truck climber, quick to send a first timer back to
Ice Cube doing freaking karate up in here. That's awesome. Devil. I wonder if he's faint. I mean, he looks familiar, but I don't know who he is. He's got to be somebody that's relevant, looks like, maybe.
Couldn't help you. That's
it. Yeah.
That's what we've been all saying.
We got martial art video movie going on.
Freaking Ice Cube doing backflips and shit.
Yeah, and the karate.
It's awesome. And he's banging with Korn.
Boy, fight one hand and buy him back.
The devil's just creepy. I think if he took the horns off,
I know.
He's still creepy a little bit.
The guy in the background is really nice. Yeah. This part I know.
Yeah. And I used to play this song earlier.
Probably the whole setup, the whole like the scenery and of it just looks legit.
Mm-hmm.
It looks like a production, like a movie.
Like a movie, yeah. I mean,
they used
to spend so much more on their videos back then.
Well, I guess it was more of a thing with they had MTV was much bigger.
Well, they had TRL,
yeah,
and you had to, you know, that was a big thing.
I think the music videos helped promote their music a lot more, so they spent more time. If you ask me, that's what I think.
This would be the stuff you saw late night, too. Obviously, clean version, but
right. This
stuff would come on at like midnight when you're half in the bag or something. You'd be like, yeah! MTV was good once, believe it or not. Dude still looks the same, too.
What year was this?
It's 96-ish.
Okay, but still the effects and everything.
This is a great video.
Yeah. Right there, 1999.
Okay. Oh, that's a little early, but that's my graduation year. No wonder it was banging. I probably banged that throughout the neighborhood. And nuts, so that's right.
Put him in the car.
The great.
But you saw it here. So, we like those.
Yeah.
Anywho.
Yeah.
Awesome video.
That's a good start.
Yeah.
I do remember the song, but not all the lyrics. Like I said, I mean, it's a pretty... said it was a big banger back then. So
it was for me anyway. And to this day, I could put it in and play it four times in a row. It's one of those things.
That's one that I could jam to, even, you know, being 10 years
younger. I mean, that's the stuff that lasts.
Yeah,
you can weightlift to it. You'd be running. You want to fight somebody or headbutt the wall.
Yeah, for sure.
Something like that. And you got the rock and rap, same.
Yeah, I mean, I'm a big rock guy. I listen to a lot of rap. And when you can combine them and make it sound awesome like that, that's good stuff.
It is. Because that era, that's what they were trying to do. You had Limp Bizkit and all that. A lot of them just kind of fell off because they didn't do it quite as well as that. I think that's...
Yeah, that's a good jam.
It is.
Yeah, so if you guys like that, like us, subscribe, hit your notification. We're going to come at you with a lot of videos like this. Some that's going to be a lot newer for me. I did know a little bit of that song. He knows a ton from that era. We're going to jump back and forth a little bit, but
yeah,
we're mainly going to stick with some of the older stuff for now because I don't know it.
Yeah. And then eventually maybe get into some underground YouTube rappers, all that stuff. Pull them out of, you know, nowhere. So
yeah, that's
we'd like to do whatever. And if you guys have a suggestion, put it in the comments.
Yeah, throw it down.
We'd like to know.
We'll listen to anything.
Yep.
Except
maybe opera or something.
I'll listen to opera.
Yeah.
Okay. It depends. Rock opera.
Heck yeah. I'm in. Rock up.
Let's do it.
Yeah. We could have a little bit of Tenacious D.
Yeah.
That's as close as I'll get to rock opera.
I love Tenacious.
Anyway, I'm Bill, your friendly neighborhood belly squirter.
This is Bubby. I don't squirt.
I don't squirt bellies.
But anyway, like and subscribe. Thanks, guys.